Many of us are working remotely using Microsoft Teams. Did you ever wonder what your boss can track about your working day? For example, how much time you actually spent working? Let's find out. Okay, so I've logged into the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Here I'm going to show you the type of information your admin has access to and what they can extract from the system. So Teams has its own dedicated admin center. Let's get to it by going to Show All and going to the Teams Admin Center. Now let's take a look at the different reports that are available to them. So under Analytics and Reports, we have different reports available here. So for example, apps usage. Let's go with the last 30 days and run the report. So here we can see the different types of apps that are used within Teams. In this case, there are 4 Microsoft apps and 2 third-party apps. Now, this information is not by user, it's in general. So we can see there are 2 active users that use Trello, there are 4 active users that use Teams, and so on. But we can't see which user used this application here. Let's go back to our reports. If your company has calling plans in place, you can get information about the number of minutes that users spent in calls and also the cost of the calls by running these reports. Under Teams device usage, you get to see what type of device they're using to get to Teams, whether it's Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and so on. What about Teams usage? Let's go and run this report and see what we get. So here we have the list of the different teams, and we get to see how many messages were posted within a team, how many replies there were, urgent messages, reactions, mentions, and meetings that were organized in the team. Now, if you click on a team here, you get to see all the members of the team, and if you click on a specific member, you can find out a bit more about their activity in Teams. For example, this person was in 2 meetings and 1 call. Under call history, you get to see all the calls that this person was in. You can also see the duration of the call and the participants. So for example, on this one, if I just click on it, I get to see who this meeting was with. The duration of the call is here, and I have more technical information about the devices they used for connection and also the IP address and so on. And let's go back to the usage reports and see what we have under the Teams user activity. When I run the report here, I get an overview of the total number of channel messages, reply messages, and so on. But here I have the display name of the people and their activity in Teams. So how many channel messages each person sent, reply messages, post messages, chat messages, total meetings. So here it's by user and not global anymore. So how many one-on-one calls there was, the total audio time, total video time, even screen sharing time, and their last activity. It doesn't have a timestamp, it just has the date of their last activity. Okay, so this is the information they can see by user. Now, what we looked at here is for Teams only, but what about the other apps? Do we get more information by person? Well, let's go back to the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Let's take a look at reports. Here we have the productivity score. Now, this is on organization level only. So here it says scores are not provided at the individual user level. This way, you get to compare your organization to a peer benchmark. It breaks it down into different categories as well, but all of this is on organizational level. Now let's go to usage and see what we get here. These reports show how people in the business are using 365 services. If I scroll down, I can see how many active users are using Microsoft 365 services, and I can see this by service. Then I get to see the Microsoft 365 apps, but again, this is general, so this is on organization level. I can't exactly see here which active user is using this app. I can also see email activity and Microsoft Teams activity, But let's take a closer look at this report here. So let's go to View More and let's scroll down. Here I get to see all the usernames and I can see their last activities for certain services. So here, when was the last time the user read or sent an email? When was the last time they did something in OneDrive or they did something in SharePoint, in Skype? Then we have Yammer here and the last activity in Microsoft Teams. Okay, so this is the information we get on user level. The other information is all available on organizational level. So this is what can be currently tracked with Microsoft Teams. In my experience working with a remote team, it's always better to assign tasks and objectives, for example, using Planner, rather than micromanaging each person and tracking their working hours. If you want to find out more about Planner, check out this video, which is going to give you a complete introduction. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, don't forget to hit that thumbs up and do subscribe to this channel in case you aren't subscribed already. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.